final match of the night.
Yes.
All right. So let me update our score. All right, Blake's laughter. It's
Oh,
you did? Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm a little late to the game here.
So here we go on Ilios. Same sort of set. Oh, no, we got a lot of switches out of Team Ruby here. So they've noticed that what they've been doing hasn't been working. Shouts opts for more defensive plays. Jet Li's also on that. So we're going to see if a little switch here is going to be able to make anything happen.
Well, we got Decurrent out of the gate again with that Widowmaker. It'll be interesting to see with his hit scan. I heard him talking strategy while I was over there awarding him, so.
Yeah, he's got a great shot, really strong hit scan, but he's getting picked up by Zave already. Oops. Nice pickup right there.
Nice. That's out of Mech Diva doing some damage.
But Team Ruby, amongst all that, still picked up the point, which means that it's going to be really, they got a free 25%-ish, and they're just keep diving right in here.
Yeah, Onyx is not letting up at all.
But they still don't have the point capped, and that's an issue right now for them, as they're losing a lot of points here, and Jet Li hops on there to extend it just a little bit longer, they're up to 36%, and they're going to be forced to regroup as Zave wraps up the end of the Pharah. So you see Yugs or Decurrent opting again for that hit scan. Didn't feel so good on the Widow.
I feel like he did that. Did he do that last round as well? Or the first round?
Yeah. Opted a little bit for that Widow play.
All right, so Ruby's coming in again, collected together, going on that left side, which always makes me leery because they're up against a Lucio, which boop opportunity is huge. We got Shreds going with the ult and almost the grab.
Just barely makes it. Shock and awe, though, is hurt bad, goes down. Carry with the ult, getting ready.
A for effort on that one. A for effort.
Yeah, Team Onyx just pushing right through him.
Onyx is really extending here. That is just staying right out of harm's way. Wow, they're really holding Ruby back here.
Oh, yeah.
Ruby, well, you can see we got D.Va coming up the side to put some pressure on them. We'll see if that makes a difference. No, she went back.
She pops her ult there.
That was,
Senpai picks up one, which is the Lucio.
That's good, though. It's a healer.
Mm-hmm. Zave just lobbing shots in there. Doing a really good job here dealing with Team Ruby.
And just to comment off that, we got a comment on Onyx in there. Fantastic. Oh, there goes Zave with an alt right in that choke point.
Only gets the D.Va mech. This is the boop. Team just collapse here. This is perfect for Zave. He's just floating just a little bit over the point, just laying into him.
And he's landing right there, recharging. That is, they are splitting Ruby apart.
Shouts, though. Managed to pick up Zave.
So there's a mention here to Onyx well use of ults, and it's very, very clear that Onyx is coordinating those ult efforts.
Yeah.
A nice first pick here on Onyx.
This is tough. You know, we talked about the mental component here.
Yes. We're seeing that again, I think, because we saw the team. Look at their coordination at the end of this round and compare it to the earlier matches where it was a more coordinated effort.
Well, you notice this rapid shifting of, like, we're going to try this, we're going to try this, we're going to try this. It's wild. But, and then you, I mean, I guess part of it's, you know, you got to adapt. Something's not working, let's change it. Makes total sense. On the flip side, though, I think it represents some level of panic where it's just, what do? We need this, try this, mix this, mix that. And when players aren't used to these players that they're playing, you might end up in a scenario where somebody's like, you know, I'm not a very good Ana, but people are saying we need Anas and I'm going to play her. Not saying that that's the case for Jet Li, but when sometimes players feel forced into roles that they're not comfortable
in these
with.
King of the Hill matches, I mean, not that it's more so than a payload, but when you're not on the point, it's draining fast. You don't have a lot of time to make those changes. You lose your ult charge.
Yep.
All right, we got some D.Va on D.Va right here, kicking it off. Did we get a Discord there? Did we get a Discord? Is that what helped that?
I think just the team in general, Senpai was on that point by herself. You know, usually it's a good idea to try and get on there quickly, but her teammates did not agree with that philosophy.
Yeah.
Team Ruby looks like they should be able to cap this, even though they've picked up a couple. And he's in the point there, just laying into
still
him.
Still contesting.
Ruby manages to draw first blood on the point, but it's not going to be enough as DeCuren runs out as quickly as he can.
Just escaped harm's way there. All right, so let's see what kind of approach they're going to go here. So it looks like they're going more towards the center as opposed to the bathhouse route, if you will.
They're just kind of picking them away, keeping them back. I think what's so challenging... Ooh, Shock and Awe managed to get taken down. What's so challenging for, I think, when you play against a really good fair is just how exhausting it can be. You know, you're always monitoring them, always dealing with them, and that's what Zave does so well.
Yep, because you're looking, again, going back to what we were talking about in the first round of matches, is that horizontal plane versus the vertical.
Yep.
I mean, that makes a big, big difference. A lot of just FPS games in general, when you throw in that vertical element, it's a totally different ballgame. Oh, and speaking of which, that's the kind of damage you get there against Yugs. With Reinhardt, you go up and over that shield with that Pharah, and it's some great splash damage. Oh.
So just relentlessly blast.
Zave is kind of mesmerized by his defense of the point here. Ruby is just coming in wave after wave.
Ooh,
and
gets eaten by Tremulous. Is all it's really cool, wow. And they managed to cap it on that. Nice work by Tremulous there. To
Shreds
keep
had
his
a great hook there as well. That was awesome.
Ooh, is he going to ult that soldier? Yes,
Yugs,
he is.
Yes, he is. He said no to that. No to that power.
Totally obliterates it. And now
is Ana
going to
get away? Yeah.
Shy Guy's able to get away. Uses the nade. Much success. They got to deal with that. Pharah.
That Zave. They just cannot shut down that Pharah this round.
Yeah. You know, you look at the traditional Overwatch Chicago team has the Mercy as like their bread and butter. Mm. Team Ruby does not have the Mercy. And you got to wonder with some of these big wipes, you know, would it have been better to have someone there to counter those alts? So I think, like was noted in chat, you know, Team Onyx is doing a great job comboing these alts, and a really good way to deal with comboed alts like that is with a Pharah that can just, or I'm sorry, with a Mercy that can just undo it. But DeCuren coming in here, just blowing them up, sees that, gotta get rid of that Mercy. Irritable goes down, nice play by DeCuren there to
good job, Ruby.
Recap a point at the last second there. So they're facing a 99.
You know they were yelling for Mercy on that. Oh, and you know they were all yelling for that. We've all been there. Because when you're starting to clean up house, if you will, you're like, where's the Mercy hiding? You got to go find her. As you were just saying earlier with the alt.
Yeah, Irritable did not have his alt up, so not too big of a threat, but you don't necessarily know that.
No, but you don't. Yeah, you don't. Not all the time, at least. All right, so there's our big damage dealer, Zave, coming up here.
Landing on the soldier, just getting so aggressive.
Ooh, a little blowback there. He hit that wall. Good opportunity for booping there when those players peek out of the side.
You can see this, you know, Zave just zipping around there, trying to deal with him. Doing a really good job.
Yeah, you can see the concussive shots mixed in there.
And the entire time that firefight's taking place, the rest of his team is pushing up through the front. But, you know, how are you able to defend as a team all these multiple fronts? And that's really where the challenge comes in, especially as he starts to get in. But Shock and Awe said, I'm done with this. I've had enough. And blows his all to just take Zave right out of the fight. And Team Ruby picks up point one.
All right.
So Ruby finally getting a little taste of victory here as we're going into match three.
So let's see, Ruby's got to be feeling pretty good right now. I mean, they feel like maybe they started to pull things together a little more towards the end of that?
Yeah, I mean, I think so. Whatever they were doing was really starting to work. You know, I think the pharmacy is a strong combination to deal with for a lot of teams. You know, that's a common issue. A lot of times when people find success with D.Va to break it up, the Zen, which they've got, you know, the double hit scans if needed. So anything to really focus and just shut a target down. So even though maybe Shock and Awe is doing great on Pharah, they might think, well, if we can totally obliterate that pharmacy, you know, we'll be in good shape. And by pharmacy, that's the Fair and Mercy combination.
Here we go, another pit map. This is good.
Yes,
a lot of exciting, exciting plays can go here. Do we have a Lucio? No. Interesting.
But we've already lost two for Team Ruby, but Ruby picks up Zave, which again is a major part. But Team Onyx capping the point uncontested.
Wow. It is funny to me that both the Divas went head to head again.
Great sleep there. Keeps the sleep up. This is the only thing keeping Team Ruby up.
Yep. Oh, and he went for the dive into the well.
You know, you gotta wonder, did that really, was that effective? I don't know, maybe.
Well, if they win at the end of the day, yeah.
Right, yeah. Bought them a little bit of time, but they're probably gonna wanna wait for their Ana to come back. It's an important target. Shakanon really needs some support here. He's kind of behind the wall. Some good group opportunities here. But Kurin goes down.
Reaching over just a tad bit to push him back.
Ooh, oh, great sleep there. Wow. Shakanon does not stick around to watch that, though, as he gets out quickly and gets blown up by Zave. On the point. Just exchanging blows, but it looks like Onyx is going to get the better half of this deal. And that's all that matters, because they're already holding the point, so they can afford to lose a little bit.
They're approaching that 50% right now.
Yes, very scary for that team, as Shrades is looking to pick somebody off here.
Oh.
Very important, keeping that shield up. Don't want to lose anything there. Trimulus is trying to get back into mech. Nice. Flashbang there. Keeps him out. Probably want to get...
A lot of out of mech D.Va damage we've seen those last two rounds, too. Oh. Alt going down.
Nobody's going to get picked up, though, which is good for Team Ruby, as they're starting to move forward on the point. They got an ult coming out here for Casey, or Carrie, but...
Is Tremulous going to pop this ult? Turn around, go over the pit?
Team Ruby manages to cap the point. Tremulous doesn't manage to get the kill on Carrie, as he managed to avoid it a little bit longer. We got some really strong ults here from all the teams.
Yeah, but we all know Onyx has some good coordination with those. So
Tremulous,
let's see.
Launches it out. That might pick up that Roadhog. She does.
Wow.
So Shakanon went down, but not before taking out a couple of Team Onyx's players, which means that they might be able to hold this just a little bit longer with their two tanks. But Dekurin goes down, which reduces one of the DPSs. So now they're looking at not such a great position. Twice Senpai tries to dive up. She's anti-healed, and she's going to end up out of mech. They're holding on to point. Is taken down by Shrades.
Huge hook.
Carrie already has another ult, which is just so difficult to deal with, as Onyx looks like they might be able to take this point without Ruby doing something, but Ruby picks up the
Ruby's
kill.
Ruby's getting close right there. We got Shoutzo with an ult, if he can get in.
Ooh, Shoutzo.
Wow.
Had the right idea there, but just was a little bit too far off point. All right, Team Onyx trying to stay alive. You know, we talked again, Team Onyx trying to stay alive. Oh, geez, man. Team Ruby trying to stay alive. I said it wrong twice.
Yeah.
Team Onyx looking to take this a 3-0. Take them out of the whole matchup here. So with the current standings, if Onyx is able to win this game right here, they're going to be walking away number one on the leaderboards with a 5-1 record. That puts Team Sapphire, right?
Yes.
Yep. Team Sapphire, number two. And then Team Jade and Team Onyx tied
for
third.
Ruby.
Oh, whatever. Look at the website afterwards. You guys will see it all there. And here we go. The fights have already started. Carrie grabbing the high ground. As they just bounce back and forth. Shoutzo gets taken out as
Onyx
Genji.
Onyx is going right in there. You see, they're both their tanks moving in right into the point.
Tremulous doing a good job running disruption. That's really what D.Va excels at, using those boops to kind of take them out. focusing on Shy Guy there, trying to deal with that Anna. He's bouncing around.
Yeah, Shy Guy really using the hops there to get out of the way.
Tremulous ends up getting bounced out, and Onyx already on the point.
Wow.
The Curren scanning the skies, looking for Xav. Knows he's up there. He's always up there. Shotso.
Look at. Did you note the shock and awe switch over to Lucio?
No, I did not. But that's interesting. So shock and awe opting to go run the healer route, which is different than what we've seen. But he's thinking maybe he can do something with that. You know, Lucio, very strong pick on this map.
And also, you underestimate that speed boost. I mean, getting the whole team there quick means a lot. Wow.
Tremulous picks up Shrades and the mech. Xav, though, dealing with them pretty well. If they're able to take out Xav here, which they are, Ruby's going to take this point.
Nice work, Ruby. And look at them get the cap the point, position themselves immediately, get their tanks out in front, and they're ready for another wave to come at them from Onyx.
Carry does not manage to get out of there, and Ruby slowly starting to tick back up with some points here. Shoutso, you can see positioned up in that upper right, trying to do a little flanky tactics. See how it pays off. So Team Ruby opting to ditch the Reinhardt. Let's see if it works out for him. Shoutso coming, he's got his all ready to pop here. He's probably looking for Jet Li to maybe ult him.
Oh, right for Anna again.
He needs that. There we go. Shoutso shredding him apart, but not before that ult comes out. Tremulous managed to pick up the
Tremulous
Mercy.
Tremulous picked up one, the Mercy, big.
Probably really important because Yertable did have his res ready to go if needed. So that could have definitely disrupted this push. Jet Li keeping the team up, doing a really good job. Opted not to use his ult on Shoutso, which I can't, you know, maybe it was worth it. I mean, they held the points. I guess it was worth it. Plus, he's got his ult left. But he's probably going to be looking to pop this on Decuren pretty soon, because that's also strong as well. Shoutso doing a great job picking up these players. Really disrupting. I think maybe this is what they needed this whole time, was a solid backline flanker. But Trades picks him up, which means that
here we go.
This is going to be an opportunity for Onyx to reclaim this point.
Well, we got the Decuren Jet Li combo coming up to defend that.
Yep. Needs to get
Onyx comes in with the monkey, but oh no. Xav and Kiwis Senpai playing the tank again as Winston cleaning it up.
All
and
right.
Irritable with the ult. And they had it safe the whole time. They had it in the pocket.
So they're 50% away from a wipe and full 3-0 on Team Ruby here. I mean, they've got some good ults. For Team Ruby to win this, they're definitely going to need to be able to use Shoutso's ult, which they do, but he's got to find that Mercy or else this is going to be for nothing.
Yeah.
He managed to pick up the Winston, but...
Anybody else? He's going after Carry, but Carry plays it safe, running back and forth through that window.
Find a lot of time for his team. Decuren picks him up. This could be strong, as Team Ruby is just inches away from capping that point. Kawhi Senpai opting for the monkey. Irritable's got to go down, or else he's going to be in it, and they do.
Xav is getting ready to pop the ult inside the house, but...
Great ult by Tremulous. Wow. Manages to keep this moving just a little bit longer. Ooh, this ult is back and forth. Carry moving on to Tracer here, bouncing around, just getting picked
Carry,
away.
Good choice,
here.
Good choice.
Extending the timer. Timer's ticking down for Team
Looks
Ruby.
Looks like Ruby's managed got
to
that.
Cap it.
Wow.
We're going to game five.
Whew. A little over.
All right. This is the final game of the night. Team Ruby making it happen here. This is in very close games.
This is definitely what we like to see here.
Team Ruby really came into their own with this pick right here on Shoutso on Genji. Those alts were just tearing apart that back line. No matter what Yurtable, Shy Guy were doing, wasn't enough. He was just nailing them. He was doing a really good job in a similar way that Xav pulls Team Ruby apart, where the half the team is scanning for him and dealing with him. Shoutso is doing the same thing to Team Onyx, just pulling them away. Mm-hmm. If you look at that alt charge already, Xav's popped a couple shots and Arnie's at 20%.
Jeez. He flies right up and over and shoots down those main pipes that they're coming in. You can just get some splash damage.
Yep. So Kwai Senpai opting to stay on this Winston and off the D.Va, which she's kind of known for playing, and manages to go down with it, but ooh!
Oh, nice recovery there.
Tremulous says no, isn't able to get it. It's Team Ruby aggressively taking over this point. Chasing him off. Might be able to pick on up, which he does. And Team Ruby draws first blood.
Nice work.
So we're letting Team Onyx regroup a little bit.
I liked Ruby's response to this. They immediately started to change their, you know, they changed up the heroes a little bit, and it shows.
Oh, yeah. The Curin might want to be saving that flashbang for that Tracer. Tries to disrupt, but Shoutso managed to finish him off. So, again, Shoutso doing a really good job keeping those healers down, dealing with them as... Xav is really close to an alt now, and he sees Shoutso as a pretty legitimate threat.
Oh, Xav is really getting that really damage thrown back at him. Now he's got his alt ready to roll, and Shy Guy does as well. So we could see a combo on the Onyx side.
But both of them go down, and the alt goes, or the combo is disrupted.
And Ruby is now stacked alts. They're ready to go.
Yep.
And if I know the timing right, they're looking at Lucio maybe being able to pop his alt off right at the tail end of whatever combo they can bring up here, especially with that Zarya. Zarya to Curren alt is something to be reckoned with.
Ooh, Shoutso taking out Kawaii Senpai real quick. Xav pops the ult. Ooh, he almost fell asleep into the pit. Gets sucked into the...
Oh, and they're all getting sucked right above the pit. No.
Shield. Everybody pops. Tremulous.
Wow.
Takes them out. And look at those ults we've got left, too. Shy Guy trying to just deal with this. If he falls, it's not going to be good. 10%.
Ruby's coming right up here at 85% full.
Needs those heals. Shoutso are doing a good job.
Okay, with Senpai up. Coming in.
Nice back and forth.
And Shoutso said no, and now we're running at the 95.
Ooh, Curren goes down. That's another big alt. Is he going to be able to pick up the Genji here? Genji flashes, picking us up the health. Carry goes down. A lot of back and forth there. Just managed to get that health.
And Shoutso knew exactly where that kit was.
Irritable's got his alt up. He can definitely keep people going here. Is he going to be able to? Picks up Yugs. Ooh, gently Save. Goes down into the pit. This looks like Team Onyx is going to be able to reclaim this point and breathe a little bit extra life back into this team. So Team Onyx picks it up, but we've got a couple good alts here, and I'm assuming they're probably going to be wanting to combo this Zarya, Genji, Anna for a full wipe.
Because they've got time now that they can do that.
Absolutely. You want to take? Yeah, you definitely don't want to rush this.
Oh, gets Yugs right in the pit.
They're all coming out of Tracer there, and it looks like they're... It's a little back and forth, but I think it might be challenging for them to get it, but they forced the res out of Yurtable, which is really good for Team
Ruby.
So I think
they got two there, right? Is that what we saw, two-man res?
Yeah, so, but even with that res, I mean, now they're in a really good position. Yeah. Shoutso knows they just got to wipe them, but... Kwai Senpai is not letting them do it. All right, you can hear call-outs from the team before there. They're keeping an eye on that Genji. They know he's going to be deadly. Tremulous really starting to pick up that Mercy, which is really great. Motion to Jet Li. You ready, bro? Let's do this. Gets ulti.
Go.
Comes in hard.
Goes picks right up for Mercy. Right for Yurtable.
Shoutso and Tremulous picks up Kwai Senpai, so it looks like they're going to have a good opportunity. But Xav, though, not letting that happen, gets around Tremulous' ult and pops him right there. We got two left on the point. They got to turn up and do it, and they do. Shot zone deflects the shot back to Xave. They successfully contest it, and we're looking at...
Oh, right here. Oh.
Kawhi sent by Suicides. This is now Tracer E. Tracer, if they're able to pick it up, but they're not, as the team regroups. This is really good for Team Ruby right now, because they hold possession of the point, so that means that the timer is not ticking to their disadvantage.
Yes.
Alt comes in for Shreds. What are they able to do with this? It's to win the game. They all fled the point. Ruby wins.
Wow.
Shocking off. Two right kills off at the end there. Manages to take the win off Carrie and Shreds.
Oh, that Lucio.
Really great play. Save plays the game. Oh, yeah, I remember this. Once you get in these close quarters, it's tough. Oh, no, I don't remember this. Oh, just aggressively boops him. Very cool play. Nice shot. 43% hook accuracy.
Nice. Well, excellent.
So that makes it two games for Onyx,
one for Ruby. So Ruby was able to at least come back with one win in that match. So they still hold on to it. It wasn't a full team wipe, which is good news.
Oh, yeah. I think it kind of is, again, it's positive to see that these teams are not, nobody's getting blown out of the water. These are really close matches. Yeah. So as these teams are playing together, we're seeing more coordination that I think makes up for differences in SR.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think one of the big things we see this season, especially week two here, is the team coordination you can't ignore. We're seeing not just like team comp, which we saw in season one. Team comp's easy. But then we started to see players start to coordinate more, and now we see more of that alt management.
Yes.
So I think that's making a huge difference, and it's causing this. And they're also they're not afraid to change. I mean, we saw some hero changes that were big, big breaks there.
So. Absolutely. So very exciting week two here. We're going to have all these games posted up this weekend and updated stats on the teams and where they're at. Again, this is still anybody's game. Anybody can still walk away winning this right now. So I guess see us next week.
And we've got our social game nights on Discord. So if you go to our website, overwatchchicago.com, you can hook up with all the players there and join us on those social nights on Tuesdays. And we'll see everybody there.
Yeah.
And thanks for watching.
Yep. Thank you, guys.